Thornbridge, Jamestown, New England IPA. And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty
beer. Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. This evening, it's all about the New England IPA. I've just tried the Northern Monk New England IPA and the Brewdog and Northern Monk collaboration that they did, the Vermont Sessions. Both were really good. I have to say, the Northern Monk stuff was absolutely amazing. That was 11 out of 10. I was in Morrison's today and I picked all these beers up. There seems to have been a delivery of UK brewers, craft brewers beer. I imagine they're having trouble getting all the other stuff in, so the shelves were quite packed with all this craft brew stuff, which I think is amazing. Morrison's are really good at that. But this was one of them. It was Thornbridge. Now, Thornbridge, for me, I like some of the stuff Thornbridge do is really good, and some of the stuff I think is overpriced mediocrity. It really is. Jaipur being one of the biggest culprits. I just think people rave on about how great that is. For me, I don't get it. I think this is very, very average. Having said that, they do some really good stuff. I love their Florida Vice. I thought that was really good. This is their Jamestown. This is the New England IPA that they do. And they're based up in Derbyshire, in a place called Bakewell. Famous for its tarts, which is unusual, because Tottenham is very famous for its tarts as well. More on that later. Anyway, let's see what this beer is all about. Right, so this is from the Thornbridge Brewery. It is a New England IPA, as I say. It's called Jamestown. It is in a purple can. There is the front of the can. It is 330ml. On the side of the can, it's got Jamestown is soft in body and huge in character. Expect a bouquet of stone fruit and citrus, followed by flavours of papaya and pineapple on the palate. Well, that is what I would expect from a New England IPA. I would expect tons and tons of fruit and big alcohol. It's only 5.9, which is sort of, you know, within the scale. You're looking at sort of, you know, between sort of 5.5 and, you know, anywhere up to sort of 8 with New England IPA. New England IPA is renowned for its strong alcohol, big fruity flavours, and just all round drinkability. I have to say, out of the two, like the West Coast IPAs and the East Coast, I do prefer the East Coast. I find them just more drinkable, more agreeable with the palate as well. I find the West Coast, some of them are just so bitter with them hops, you know, the Citra hops and stuff like that. I do find that they're, you know, after one or two, I'm sort of struggling with the bitterness. But I am digressing. Yeah, as I say, it's 5.9%. It's in a 330ml can. All that remains is to get this open and to get this drunk. Right, so let's get it open and see what is on the nose out of the can. Yeah, and as I say, this evening I've just been drinking New England's and this smells very like the Northern Monk stuff. Plenty of fruit, plenty of tropical fruit, little bit of grapefruit bitterness, and not a lot else. It's a little low on the aroma. Let's get it into the glass and see what gives. Now, these should be very cloudy, very orangey, and full of fruit. Wow, that is fucking lively. This is a 440ml glass. I've just poured that into I've just poured a 330ml can into that. Still a little bit left. That has got a fucking huge four finger head. Well, yeah, roughly four fingers. Colour's nice though. Nice and hazy, as you would expect. Not as colourful as the other Northern Monk that I was drinking just now. I'm going to compare the two because they're both craft brewers. They're both brewing a New England IPA. So you'd expect similar characteristics. That's why I'm going to compare. And to be fair, the Northern Monk was, for me, it was a 10 out of 10 standout beer. One of the best. So that's going to be the benchmark. So there's a fair bit of carbonation in that. It's a very light sort of lemon yellow colour. Huge head on that. Very lively carbonation. Loosely formed head. Big bubbles on that. On the nose, out of the glass, what are we getting? Yeah, more of the same. Sweet fruit. Sweet tropical fruit. Little touch of pine, but it's mostly grapefruit bitterness and sweet fruit that's coming out. Let's get it down the hatch. What is on the palate? Bit of a curveball on that one. I was all set to pan that. I thought, this hasn't got much body. Then all of a sudden, I was hit with a huge surge of biscuit malt and spice, if you can imagine that. So what are you getting? Well, the initial first mouthful, bitterness, then your fruit. You got your pineapple, you got your grapefruit bitterness, you know, as you first go down, but then you got your, as I say, you got your pineapple, you got your mango, your peach, all your sweet stone fruits. That's what you get. And it feels, the body feels a little touch watery. And then you let that go down. And as I was just about to say, don't think much of this. All of a sudden, right at the end, you just get a big surge of sort of biscuit malt and a bit of spice, like peppery spice. Which is unusual and interesting. Yeah, and to be honest, this is the first one that's had a bit of a malty backbone on it. Biscuit malt. Which is quite long lasting. But there's a lot of spice on that as well. I am getting like peppery, white pepper spice. And it isn't bad. It's not bad at all. I was all set to panic with that. What I thought was quite watery body on it. And then as it went down, all of a sudden, there was this big, malty backwash of biscuit malt and a bit of spice, which mixed in with all the fruit gave you a lot of flavour. And it's not bad. Now, I'm going to compare it with the two that I tried earlier. The Brewdog stuff, that had a lot of pineapple hop bitterness. Sorry, grapefruit hop bitterness all the way through. And that was a feature of the Brewdog and the Northern Monk collaboration. The Northern Monk New England IPA. That was very fruity, really nice, really drinkable. 7.1 as well, so bigger than both of them. The Thornbridge stuff and the Brewdog stuff. Bigger alcohol content, but you would not notice it. You'd probably notice a bit more in these two. Not with that. This one has got more spice and it's got more malt on it. And do you know what? It doesn't mention the malty backbone on it, which it has got. It's got a really good biscuit malt. And I would be making big things about that. It's like a rich tea biscuit. With some spice. And you do get a bit of a dry mouth feel on it as well. And a little touch of bitterness as well on the end. This is quite good from Thornbridge. I've had a few from them, and to be honest, as I say, they've been pretty average. This is quite nice. New England is my favourite style of IPA, I have to say. And they can be hit and miss. You know, I've tried some good ones, and I've tried some pretty terrible ones, to be honest. This isn't too bad. No complaints really at all. There's nothing in there that's making me think this doesn't taste right, or, you know, they could have done something better. It's not bad. All the flavours they talk about, I mean, them stone fruits they're talking about, like, you know, the expect a bouquet of stone fruit and citrus, followed by flavours of papaya and pineapple. There is that papaya and the pineapple on there. That's your sweet fruit. I thought it was more peachy, but there is a malty back end on this with some spice, and that really sets it off, and I'm liking that. I think that's good. So what's the verdict? Well, to be honest, I tried two Thornbridge beers recently and I wasn't impressed. And I just thought, they're going through the motions. And I was out and about the other day, and I had a can of Jaipur, and I vowed never to drink it again. I really don't like it. I do remember that being really good, and now all of a sudden, it's pretty shit. They've done something to it, and maybe it's the supermarket, the curse of the supermarket, you know, where you've got to, you know, you're under pressure to get out bigger batches, etc. But it didn't taste that great. This, on the other hand, this is not bad. I quite like this. I would give this an 8.5 out of 10. I don't think it's as good as the Northern Monk stuff. That's just, you know, admittedly it was 7.1% and it's full bodied. The Brewdog stuff, again, I don't think it matches up to the Brewdog and Northern Monk Vermont Sessions New England IPA. But what it's got going for it, it does introduce some new flavours to the New England style. It's got that spice, almost Belgian-esque, if you like, with the pepper. And it works. And the malt on the back end as well, which I think, you know, a good New England should have. And that is a solid 8.5 out of 10. And I'd recommend it. Get yourself down at Morrison's. And remember, beer is working class champagne.